Welcome students. Now we are going to learn about the new lesson, new questions and ideas. Aim: to describe the teachings of Buddhism and Jainism. To explain the main ideas of the Upanishads. Some important keywords related in this lesson are Buddhism, Buddhism, suffering, suffering, meditated, meditated, soul, soul, universal, universal, monk, monk, non-violence, non-violence, sanghas, sanghas, slave, slave, monastery, monastery. Students, who said ahimsa and non-violence? Yes, Gautama Buddha thought about practicing ahimsa and non-violence. Who is this Buddha? Siddhartha Gautama, the founder of Buddhism, who later became known as the Buddha. He was born in 624 BC in Lumbini, located in the Nepal. His parents was Suddhodana and Mahamaya Devi. Siddhartha was the prince of small Gana named Sakya. One day, he wished to go on a ride on his chariot. Siddhartha saw the suffering of many people, like an old man, a sick man, and a dead man. He wanted to know about life, death, and suffering. He left home and wandered, meeting different thinkers, and then meditated for days. He meditated under a peepal tree at Bodh Gaya, which is in Bihar. After meditating, he realized the answers to his questions. He realized that suffering is caused by the endless desires and greed of people. Siddhartha finally became enlightened. He came to known as Buddha. The Buddha taught us that we can end suffering by controlling our desires. According to the Buddha, the actions of person would affect his own life, both the present and next life. He taught people to treat everyone being with kindness and respect. References to Buddhism are found in the Tamil epic Manimegalai. Kanchipuram was a center of Buddhist teachings. Chinese pilgrims Xuan Shuang visited Kanchipuram in the 7th century CE. Buddha traveled on foot to different places, spreading his message to people. The first place he taught after attaining enlightenment was Sarnath. He used the Prakrit language to teach as it was used by the common people. This is the stupa at Sarnath, the first place where Buddha taught his messages. Next, we are going to learn about the new ideas which arose in the Vedic religion. How did people worship gods? The Vedic religion mainly had rituals and sacrifices, which were performed by the Brahmins. Some thinkers questioned the importance of these sacrifices and rituals. Other thinkers focused on questions about life after death and came up with new ideas which were written in the Upanishads. Upanishad, which literally means approaching and sitting near, refers to the students who sit near their teacher or guru to gain knowledge. The Upanishads connect the individual and the universe through the idea of the soul. According to the Upanishads, there is a universal soul or Brahman, which cannot be destroyed and is present in every living being as Atman or individual soul. Therefore, the Atman is a part of the Brahman. The Upanishads teach us that every individual soul is connected to the universal soul. Brahmins developed the system of ashramas. This is the stages of life that one should follow. These four ashramas were Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha and Sannyasa. The Brahmacharya refers to the childhood stage when a person, mainly the male child, had to study the Vedas. Then the Grihastha was the stage of an adult man who had to marry and live a family life. In the Vanaprastha, man had to leave the luxuries of a family life to live in a forest and meditate. Finally, he had to give up everything and become a sannyasi, where he had to meditate. Next, we are going to learn about the ideas of another religion called Jainism. Jainism was not a new religion, but it became popular during the time of Mahavira. Vartamana Mahavira was one of the Jaina thinkers. He was the prince of Lichavi clan, which was a part of the Vajji. Like Siddhartha, he also left home at the age of 30 and went to live in a forest. He wandered for 12 years and lived in a hard life, trying to conquer his desires. After all these years, Mahavira finally attained enlightenment. Jainism teaches us to practice non-violence and not to hurt any living being. Both Jainism and Buddhism teach us to respect the life of every living being. Both religions required people to leave their homes to attain true knowledge. A Sangha was organized for all the followers who left their homes. Many of the followers built shelters for the monks of the Sanghas to rest. These shelters were called Viharas or monasteries. These monasteries were usually made of wood and brick. These Viharas were maintained by rich traders, merchants and kings who donated land, food and other things to the monks. Next, we are going to learn about conditions of Vedic society. Vedic society was divided in the four Varnas: the Brahmins, the Kshatriyas, the Vaishyas and the Shudras. Brahmins were the most respected in society because they performed all the Vedic rituals. The Vaishyas, who were traders, merchants, herders and craft persons. The Vaishyas were treated as more taxpayers. Some of the traders and merchants of this Varna were rich, but did not enjoy the privileges and importance given to the Brahmins and kings.
the Shudras who served the other three Varnas. They were not allowed to study the Vedas. The Varna system was very strict and did not allow for changes in its rules. As a result, the Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, Shudras and women may have started to question the Vedic practices and therefore started to support the new ideas promoted by Buddhism and Jainism. The language of the Vedic religion was Sanskrit, which was not understood by the common people. The new ideas of Buddhism and Jainism were taught in the Prakrit language, which was spoken by ordinary people. Therefore, it was easier for them to understand these new ideas.
Buddhism, Jainism and Upanishads had simple ideas such as respecting every living being and never hurting any living being. This must have appealed to the Shudras and women who felt ignored and disrespected in Vedic society. Most importantly, these ideas believed in treating everyone with equal respect. Okay students, today we have studied the different ideas that emerged in the form of Buddhism, Jainism and the Upanishads. All of these ideas talk about a way of living and non-hurting any living being. Okay, thank you students.